Welcome back to Philadelphia. John Butchergrass, Ray Ferraro, Emily Kaplan. Let's take a look at tonight's starting goalies brought to you by American Express. Carter Hart, 24 years old, coming off a couple of bumpy campaigns. What will the story be in between the pipes for the Flyers this year? Meanwhile, the Devils used seven goalies last year. They had a team worst 881 save percentage. They hope that Mackenzie Blackwood can come back from a down year and give them stability in net and maybe be a team that is sniffing the playoffs at year's end. Of course, the top story in this game tonight, the head coaching debut in Philadelphia of John Tortorella. Our ESPN co-worker a year ago is now back behind the bench. And this, the Flyers, home opener. The Eagles are cooking. The Phillies are in the playoffs. The Sixers are going to have a good team again. What about the Flyers as they open up their campaign? Their fans are ready. And we're underway in Philadelphia. The debut of John Tortorella behind the bench of the Flyers. Devils in white, Flyers in orange. Fourth line out there to begin things for the Devils. We had John Tortorella mic'd up before the game. You'll hear his comments to his players before they took to the ice after our first whistle. We'll have our first icing of the game, and John Tortorella talking to his team.
Level assists. It's not about winning and losing. We need to develop a process of an identity of who we are. Wins will take care of themselves, okay? We're not wasting any time. Game one. So all the little things, not winning and losing, not the big body checks, all the little things of how hard we're going to be to play against. That's who we're going to be.
And let's see how it goes. And the Flyers with the puck, and they get out of their zone as the top line out there. Hayes, Lawton, and Konechny. There's Jack Hughes. Again, 1.14 points per game last year. Could he be the first Devil ever to get 100? What's the early pace down there for the Flyers, Ray Ferraro?
A little tentative, and I think there's going to be some nervousness, not just for the start of the season, but in playing for John. And quite simply, he's very demanding, and you heard in his talk, he's not worried about the systems. He wants to find out, to separate who wants to be part of this program going forward and who just can't hold the pace that he wants to hold them accountable to.
What a year Jesper Bratt had last year. He can really fly in the offensive zone. One of the most exciting young players in the NHL. Just a one-year contract. They tried to lock him up long-term. They couldn't quite get to that figure. And so he's back to try to prove it again.
That'll be a little internal thing to keep an eye on is, you know, does Bratt feel slighted? Does he relax? Can he duplicate what he did? He wants a big number.
Puck loose in front, man knocked down, play continues. That's Wade Allison in front, shot off the post! Inches away from taking an early lead. Sanheim throws it in front, just signed a new contract extension before the game. Another pass in front as the Flyers are buzzing, but the Devils get it out of the zone. Jared Govich will dump it. So inches away were the Flyers from taking a 1-0 lead. Here come the Flyers again now looking to break out. Tatar in there for the Devils. And Carter Hart will cover up and get a whistle.
Erwin Allison's got a great shot. 10 goals in 28 games last year in the American Hockey League, but he's also going to get to the front of the net. He gets a screen in on Blackwood, who doesn't get a look at it. The shot goes through Blackwood, rings off the right post, and for a guy trying to get his feet wet after a long year, Mackenzie Blackwood has the first one ring, and maybe a good bounce for him this time.
Yeah, Justin Braun with that shot from the point, the 35-year-old defenseman. Shot from the point this time by the Devils, knocked down by Cart in front, as Severson was walking the line and got a shot on goal. Here comes Hayes, gets it poked away. And Konechny will regroup. Konechny led this team in points last year with 52. Here he comes, wheeling through the neutral zone. He'll dump and chase it himself. trying to beat the rush. There's big Ryan Graves behind the net. Lawton with a big hit. Provorov with the aggressive pinch. Konecny back in front. Lawton backhand save by Blackwood, and he covers up the first big save. And this is what we expect to see more of from the Flyers this year with John Tortorella behind the bench.
The foundation of any Tortorella team is work. It's pride. And the Flyers fell flat last year in a long year where not much went right for them. They have a couple of great scoring chances early. The Braun off the post, and now a scramble chance off from behind the net that starts with great work from Travis Konecny twice in on the forecheck. One time the body on Ryan Graves, and there a steal off of McLeod turnover. Lawton is the beneficiary, and when he gets wrapped up, here comes everybody else in orange. Pretty tentative start with a puck for the Devils, and the Flyers have been on top of it. Blackwood with the save as the scrum dissipates to the left of Blackwood.
Fourth line out there, including Nick Deslauriers. He was signed in the offseason. A pretty rich contract for a guy that doesn't produce a lot. But you already saw him talking with Bastion right there on the faceoff, Ray. He may be asking to go. If there's going to be a pull on first Flyer to fight tonight, I think it's going to be Deslauriers.
Yeah, probably good, pretty good money on it. Now, Deslauriers, they loved him in Minnesota. Did a tremendous job after he came over to them. Then he's a free agent. They just couldn't afford to sign him, and he ends up in Philly.
Yeah, 1.75 for 4 years. That's a good deal for him. Again, just 13 points last year, but he's an energetic guy. The Flyer fans will love him. He hits everything that moves, and he'll fight as well. Number 44 goes to the bench for a change. Now the Devils try to find their feet with head coach Lindy Ruff, of course, back. Mercer, shot, deflected high into the netting. We mentioned Lindy Ruff. Talked to him before the game, Ray, and he felt some nervousness from his team as expectations have risen.
And whether you think you're ready for them or not, the expectations are there. One thing Lindy made perfectly clear is they have to give up way fewer goals against. 307, 28th in the league last year. So it's not a style change. For us, it's effort and it's commitment.
Hughes down, shot saved by Carter Hart. Nice save, short side high as Brendan Smith came down the left wing, the defenseman. There's Jack Hughes, Ray, just creating offense.
Yeah, Ray, the Hughes just telling Smith, yeah, you're open there, you go down the wing. And Brendan Smith, who came over from Carolina, you're gonna see him peel out, now slide down the wing. Owen Tippett stuck. Do I let Hughes skate or do I try to get the puck out of his hands? He makes a good defensive decision to get the puck out of Hughes' hands. Smith with the shot, and it's a nice stop for Carter Hart.
Mercer takes the face-off on the right dot. There's Hughes on the left dot. Mercer playing the wing. No Nico Hischier tonight, so the Devils had to jumble their line. A little bit. There's a big hit from behind. Man down.
That's a bad hit.
Mercer comes over to support his teammate Smith as he was going back for the puck. For now, looks like there'll just be the one penalty. There's Brendan Smith, who just had the opportunity to score. You see him kind of shake that left shoulder. Tough kid. Looks like for now he's okay. More maybe scared and the wind knocked out of than anything as Wade Allison will go to the box in an early double power play.
Actually, Owen Tippett's going to go to the box here. It's going to be a boarding penalty, I
Philadelphia
believe.
Number 74, 2 minute minor penalty for boarding.
As Smith starts to lose his footing towards the goal line, Tippett's got a layoff right here. You see him give him the shove right there. It looks almost like he's trying to grab him at the end as he sees that Smith is out of control right here. He's out of control. Man, that's such a dangerous play. Anytime you get within those couple feet of the boards, there's just no time to protect yourself. Looks like Smith is okay. Tippett's in the box for the first penalty of the Flyers season. And here's the Devils' power play that was a mess last year.
There's Andre Palat, newly acquired in the offseason from the Tampa Bay Lightning, the free agent. Signed a rich deal. He has the puck now. Back to the point to Dougie Hamilton, another key guy on this power play. Tatar's out there in the bumper. Left point, huge wrist shot block, never got there. And Joel Farabee will clear.
One of the things that Jack Hughes did so much better last year and far more frequently is take the puck and aggressively look for his shot instead of just looking to be the disher, the facilitator. He shoots more, that opens up more for everybody else.
Eric Halla acquired in the offseason from the Boston Bruins for Pavel Zacha out there on the power play. Hamilton, Palat, back to Dougie Hamilton. Hughes can't quite handle it. Hughes was out there for a while on the previous shift, but Lindy Ruff stayed with him.
You always got more juice when the power play starts.
Let's take a look at some numbers from the SAP Coaching Insight app. As you see, their lowest power play percentage last season. Both these teams on that list.
It's always interesting early in the year. You try to balance out the power plays. You know, on two good groups. Some work, some don't, and then you're going to have to make some adjustments as time goes on.
Brad back out there playing catch with Mercer. Youngster Alexander Holtz out there nine. 20-year-old Swede. They're looking for big things from him. If they can get number 10 open, he can really shoot it.
26 goals in the American League last year. Now the trick is, can the 20-year-old find his way at the NHL level?
He's number 10 in white. He's going to try to get this puck before Braun gets there, but Braun wins the battle. But Mercer, nice play to Severson. Shot to the point, just deflected wide. Miles Wood providing a screen in front for the Devils. Number 44, back in healthy. Here's Brad, the dangerous Brad. Cross it goes, but fanned on the shot is Holtz. Back to Brad. The two work together in the offseason. Brad has some room. Shot deflected twice behind the net. There's Wood. Watched by Braun. Pratt will race it down. 5-on-5 hockey again. Wood, blind pass to nobody. In fact, it goes right to the Flyers and cleared out. Lozinski, one-handed sweep. Four shots on the power play for the Devils. Puck in the corner. Back to Marino. Smith back out there. Give and go. He'll attack the net. To the net goes McLeod. Puck is loose. Penalty coming up. Another power play. Holding's going to be the call.
Frost got beat off the sideboards. And for the second time, the Devils are going to go to the power play in a 0-0 game. Two early power plays.
ESPN Plus Hockey Night presented by New Amsterdam Vodka, the official vodka of the NHL. Drink responsibly. Flyers taking some BP, going deep at Citizens Bank. There's Kevin Hayes, OFD, originally from Dorchester. There's Schwarbs, always sleeveless, giving Kevin Hayes and the Flyers some pointers. As the Flyers are in the playoffs, they'll be big weekend here, hey Ray, for the Flyers and the Eagles and the Phillies fans.
Yeah, you don't have to go too far to find a playoff game here. Up the ramp, straight ahead's the Eagles, then they'll have the Cowboys here Sunday night, and the Phillies are back in the playoffs, and it's a great sports city here, in a great location, all the venues tight together.
Yeah, an ultimate sports city, and it's an ultimate sports weekend. Here come the Devils back on the power play. Hamilton shot, never got there. Duck hit Tatar in front in the bumper. And the Flyers clear. So two early penalties the Flyers have to defend here in the early going. 7 minutes in, just one shot for the Flyers, two for the Devils. Jack Hughes off the TV timeout is nice and fresh now, but he can't enter the zone. Good play by Lawton. Kevin Hayes out there to kill a penalty. And alone. Takes it behind, bad angle shot, good try. Trying to bank it in off Blackwood, but here come the Devils the other way. Hughes with Holla. Holla has it. Good hands to Hamilton. Palat wants it. Hamilton gets it to him. And Andre Palat will scan the situation and goes back to Hamilton. Back to Palat. Down low, here comes Hughes, but it bounces over his stick as Holla tried to make the pass. Kevin Hayes got a stick on that.
Really interesting. Palat playing out on the half wall in Tampa Bay. There's no room at the end there. That's where Nikita Kucherov is. Palat's down in the, either in the bumper or right in front of the net. So new team, new role, new space for Palat.
Mercer, here come the Devils with numbers. Shot in and score! Goal number one, and look who gets it. The 20-year-old Alexander Holtz, his first NHL goal, gives the Devils a 1-0 lead.
A couple of things on this is there's Holtz's first NHL goal. Congratulations to him, and a puck that goes right through Carter Hart. But this play's made by Jesper Bratt. Look at the hands in the middle of the ice. That's a sweet dish over Justin Braun's stick. And this from a relatively sharp angle goes between the glove and body of Carter Hart. Little dish there. Nice play by Bratt. And this goes over the pad, under the glove, and into the net. And Alexander Holtz will never forget that shot.
Just his 10th NHL game. He gets his first NHL goal. Dawson Mercer was on the doorstep trying to maybe tip that in, but it kind of went off the post and into the net, and the Flyers are down 1-0. Blackwood, another save with the blocker to keep it 1-0. Hey, Arto, Cal, more openers going around in the NHL.
Absolutely. The Penguins and the Coyotes opening up their campaigns, and it is Sidney Crosby. How about that? First goal from Guentzel. And then Jason Zucker would make it 2-0. This is the 1-0 goal once again. It was so nice. Let's see it twice. But it's 2-0 now thanks to Jason Zucker, Bucci.
His career goal 518 for Sidney Crosby. As the Penguins off to a good start. Provorov shot, rebound, score! Wayne Allison ties the game. In 23 seconds. He played just one game last year, Ray. Didn't score a goal. He's on the board in his first this year.
Yeah, both teams talked about the need for better goaltending. It's 1-1, and these are rotten goals at either end. Hartz goes right through him. This hits Blackwood right in the chest. Thank you very much, says Wade Allison, as this biscuit drops right in his feet and he shoots it into the empty net. For the Devils, that's a save Blackwood has to make. The Flyers rebound after one that Hart should have made, and we're right back to square one.
Give Provorov an assist on that as well. Played 4 years at Western Michigan. It's been a frustrating pro career for the 25-year-old Wade Allison, but that's got to feel really good with a new coach and a new year to try to get things going. It's people like Allison and Farabee who need to produce for this Flyers team if they're going to have any shot of being respectable this year in the Eastern Conference.
Well, they talk about how they like the motor that Allison has, that he's aggressive, he'll get to the front of the net. Tortorella talked after learning about him a bit at camp, because that's part of the process here too. He's got to learn these guys, is they want him to play a little bit more structure, but they don't want him to lose that jump.
Back come the Devils, ripped wide there of Carter Hart by Thomas Tatar. And the Devils are circling again. Hamilton goes D to D. Shot blocked in front, almost deflected. Past Hart, still alive. Another shot, kick save by Hart. As once again, it's Holtz out there, filled with all kinds of confidence and adrenaline after that first NHL goal. Tatar has room. Dumped in the corner there by Siegenthaler. Now the Devils are given good pressure, but they'll look to change now after a good shift. Myers regrouping. D'Angelo just going to get it out of there and try to get off the ice, and fresh troops on now. Two quick goals here midway through the first. Some shoving matches, some chirping, a couple of goals. Good early entertainment for these Flyer fans who haven't had much to cheer about the last couple of years. Here comes Mercer now. He got an assist on that Holtz goal. Arm in the air, penalty coming up. Looks like it's going to be the Flyers who are going to go on the power play.
Alexander Holtz got his first of his NHL career, and then Wayne Allison, a rebound moments later. It's 1-1.
Welcome back to Philadelphia. Emily Kaplan just spoke with John Tortorella.
What do you think your team start?
We're okay. I think we're a little bit nervous with the puck. We're trying to do the things on the wall. I think we're doing okay.
How close does this look like to what you want to see in Flyers hockey?
Yeah, we're a ways away from that. It's going to be a process. I think we got a ton to do. Each game that comes by, hopefully we get better.
Thanks, John.
My pleasure.
Power play Flyers. D'Angelo out there with Tippett. D'Angelo's an excellent power play quarterback, number 77, trying to improve on the worst power play in the NHL last year. Konechny out there. Van Riemsdyk will take shot right in front of the crease. Shot deflected high off the netting. And whistle blows. Again, 12.6% last year, the worst in the league.
James Van Riemsdyk, still one of the better players around the front of the net. Excellent at redirecting pucks, finding little short tight end plays. A good year last year. John Tortorella will lean on him a little bit on the power play. I thought it was interesting in John's talk with Emily Kaplan was that we're a ways away. He keeps talking about the patience that's going to be needed to get the Flyers to where he wants them to be. It's not a quick fix.
Tippett, quick pass to Kevin Hayes.
Broken Hayes. Stick for Stiegenhaller here. They're one man short with a stick. Now Haller without it.
Konecny in the bumper. He's open if they want to go to him. Down to the net. Tip by Van Riemsdyk. Rebound, no. Another save by Blackwood. Puck is loose. Trying to fish it out. Konecny does. Back to the point, but D'Angelo had moved to the middle of the ice, and he wasn't there. They can't take advantage of the broken stick. But quickly, they're back in the zone with Konecny. In front, deflected away by McLeod, but stays in the zone. Van Riemsdyk. Tip it behind the net. Konecny has it back to D'Angelo, and the Flyers are set up. Shot! Blocked in front. That was Siegenthaler, number 71, and the Devils clear.
Siegenthaler's turned into a good player for the Devils, led them their team in hits, came in a trade from Washington and signed a five-year extension. He's really become a solid player for them.
Yeah, just $3.4 million. That's a good team deal. You can see him being a very good defensive stay-home guy for a long time for these Devils. So to get him inked up for 5 years and 3.4, I'm sure Tom Fitzgerald in the Devil front office is very happy. He said yes, and he said that, yeah, I probably did take less than I deserve, but it's not all about the money. He wants to be here. He's enjoying it here, and that kind of contract, Ray, will guarantee he'll stay here.
Yeah, that's not going to hurt.
Here comes Severson. Tries to dangle around Zamula, but he can't. The defenseman deep in the corner.
He's an interesting kid here, Zamula. 6'3", about 175 pounds. If he can ever fill out, he's got a good head for the game. He moves the puck pretty well.
Yeah, just his 11th NHL game for Zamula. Still looking for his first NHL point. Good hard hit by Delorier. There he is again, number 44. He's a crash test dummy. He'll hit everything that moves, number 44. Has it now. Looking at some offense. Oh, nice defensive play in front by Marino as Delorier had a man in front. Flyers now behind the net. They look good right now. They some energy and some confidence. Wrist shot blocked again in front by the Devils. It's Graves. A couple of big defensive defensemen like Siegenthaler and Graves who will eat pucks even in game number one. Lazinski with the puck, former Ohio State Buckeye. He centers this fourth line. Allison's out there as well with Delorier. Allison keeps it in. Delorier fishes it down. Good shift by the Flyers, but this time it comes out. Allison can't keep it in, but a nice move to the neutral zone to get right back in the zone. Gets knocked down from behind. Crowd wants a penalty. They don't get one.
He's had a good start, not just the goal, but showed a little bit of his strength on top of the puck.
Lawton now. He'll go chase this down. Dougie Hamilton, he goes right for the hit. As the Devils come back now. Proveroff, they're going to call icing on that one, and the faceoff will come to the double end. Alexander Holtz, 10th NHL game, scored his first NHL goal. Wade Allison, just his 16th NHL game. He scored a goal, fifth of his career. He had 4 2 years ago in just 15 games played. He's been injured, only played one game last year, didn't score. Konecny's shot is blocked. Comes back to Proveroff, to the point. Saved by Blackwood as it gets him right in the chest.
Flyers are moving around the offensive zone pretty well here. There's a couple of good shifts where they've had back-to-back and a little heat.
Oh, what a weekend it is for this sports-crazed city of Philadelphia. It's the Flyers tonight, the Phillies, and the Eagles all playing in Philadelphia. Thank you, Arda. Flyers 1-4 in the preseason. Carter Hart didn't suit up for a game, but he's in there tonight. And So far, so good for the Flyers. First period almost in the books. 1-1 game here against the Devils. Here's Sealer with the puck now. Pokes it in deep. As the Devils play some board play. Stolen by Van Riemsdyk. Shot in front. Just wide. You heard John Tortorella once. Strong wall play. Strong board play. And he's getting that. He's forced a few turnovers tonight. Goes off Miles Wood. Saved there by Hart. And he covers up, so the Devils will have an offensive zone faceoff. 8 shots for the Flyers, just 4 for the Devils, Raymond.
Yeah, you know, I'm thinking about that board work that John Tortorella's talking about, and that's all just an extension of what the foundation of what he wants his Flyers to play like, and that is to win puck battles. It's when you don't win the puck battle, you get on the inside of their players so they don't get to your net. It's about work. It's about commitment. It's a real simple message. But it's hard day after day to provide it. And that's what he's going for.
Devils haven't had a shot on goal in almost 5 minutes. See if they can get one here with about 5 minutes to go. Marino, Siegenthaler, snapshot in front, redirected high by Bratt. Taken there by Holla. Back to Marino, snapshot towards the net, blocked there in front by Frost. Open, save by Hart, just goes wide off the Holla shot. Stick knocked out of his hands. Van Riemsdyk will take it out. Softly chips it around the wall, tries to go around Severson. Taken there by Marino. Under 5 to go here in the first. John Butchergrass, Ray Ferraro, Emily Kaplan here on ESPN Plus. It's the Flyers and the Devils' first game of the year. Back come the Devils. Mercer trying to pass it in front, gets it back, looking backhand, saved by Hart. And the Flyers get it out again. Nice big hip check there by Mercer. Jack Hughes is back on the ice. Goes to Palat. And Dougie Hamilton. So no Heischer tonight. Mercer playing wing with Hughes and Palat. And that's going to be an icy. Hey, this reminder, here's a look at some of the featured upcoming games on the NHL schedule. Saturday, the Lightning are in Pittsburgh to take on the Penguins, NHL Network. Our ESPN Plus game Tuesday has the Lightning hosting these Flyers. John Tortorella returns to where he won a Stanley Cup. TNT's doubleheader. Don't forget to get ESPN Plus. Go to ESPNplus.com or download the ESPN app. Emily Kaplan, ringside.
Guys, Brendan Smith has not been out there the last few shifts for the New Jersey Devils. I'm told he went down the tunnel. We'll get word, but he did get dinged up on that big hit early in the first.
Yeah, looked like he was shaking that left shoulder as Jack Hughes comes into the Flyer zone. No one is better at controlled entries than Jack Hughes. His numbers were off the charts last year. Gained the zone with the puck and then creating offense.
Yeah, third in the league for Hughes. Couple of pretty good players in front of him, McDavid and Johnny Gaudreau.
Yeah. Penalty coming up again on the Flyers. So the Devils will go on their third power play at the next whistle, unless they can score with the extra attacker. Delorier has enough control of that to get the whistle. So with 3:42 to go in the first, it's power play number 3 for the Devils.
As you balance aggressiveness with discipline, the Flyers have taken a couple here.
Philadelphia number 21, 2 minutes for cross-checking.
Scott Laughton is the latest Flyer to go to the bench. And well, the play's over here. Him and Tatar wrapped up, and he doesn't. Yeah, the penalty's not there. He's,
right
I guess
there.
It's right there.
Right in front of you.
Yeah. It's funny, though. You know what? I didn't even notice
right.
It. It's right in front of me, and I didn't even notice it.
Right. And that's why sometimes we see an official call a penalty from 50 feet away. Sometimes the ref right next to it doesn't have the perspective. Power play, Devils. See if they can take a 2-1 lead. Here's Andre Palat, as Ray mentioned, playing the Kucherov position when he was in Tampa Bay. Jack Hughes, Palat, looking, shot blocked. Good stick play there by Tatar. Backhands it back to Palat, give and go. Hughes will keep it in. Jack Hughes. Cross Palat whacks it towards the net. Nice play by Carter Hart, but Holla runs it down. Here's Hamilton. 4 forwards and Dougie Hamilton. Palat, Hughes, shirt to target. Stick checked nicely by Farabee. Shot Hamilton deflected wide. Good defensive play by Farabee, killing penalties. Hughes looking. Tatar threw it over to Palat. Can't connect. Gives the Flyers a chance to regroup. Down low. Here's Holla. Goes to Hughes. Always a good move. Hamilton. Shot. Deflected just wide. Hughes will keep it in. Hughes walking in. Curl. Shot just wide of Hart. He gets knocked down. And the Flyers are able to clear.
This setup for the Devils has Dougie Hamilton as a shooter at the point, but no real big one-time threat on it.
30 seconds to go in the power play. Here's Mercer. Miles Wood out there. Drops it back, but it comes right to connecting. The Flyers have some numbers if they go, even though shorthanded. Here they come now. Braun makes a smart play. Delorier's around the other side. He's there along the wall, trying to kill some time, but Mercer gets it quickly. Here comes a dangerous Bratt. So silky, number 63. Pass in front. Holtz tries for number two. Can't get it to go. Miles Wood tried it a couple of times, and the Flyers survive as they get the puck out. Hayes back on the ice. Sanheim can't get it over to Hayes, and the Devils clear. Eight shots apiece now here in Philadelphia. Off post number two. Rebound in front as James Van Riemsdyk hit the post. So Braun and JVR both hit the post for the Flyers here in the first. McLeod out there now. Gets knocked down. As the wall play continues again, John Tortorella talked about being strong on the wall, and the Flyers have been. Heard the 1 minute to go call in the first period. That was Noah Cates with the big hit. One of the more impressive Flyers in the preseason. Won a national championship for Minnesota Duluth. John Tortorella really impressed with Cates' play in the preseason. And he delivered a hard hit right there. Puck kept in by Severson. Knocked down the front. Two players collide. They're both down and a save by Hart. It's Tippett and Palat. And now another push in front. Some glove punches thrown by Lawton. D'Angelo body slams behind the net.
Well, Palat's a little shaken up in the slot here. He and Tippett ran into each other. I don't think they really saw each other. They're both shaken up. Palat looks like he took the worst of it. And then the scrum broke out around Carter Hart. As you see Palat slowly back to the box.
Philadelphia number 77, New Jersey number 14, both players, 2 minutes each, roughing.
So a couple of roughing penalties, but here's that collision, Ray, right there.
And they don't really see each other, and an awkward fall for them both. The shot and the clean out in front as Hart had to scramble back into position. He ends up making a good save. That's through traffic. He swallows it up nicely, and D'Angelo and Bastian get into it to the side of the net, and Bastian trips over the back of the net, and D'Angelo's got all the momentum. They end up on the ice, scrumming it up behind the Flyer goal.
And again, Bastian did nothing there. He was actually just standing. But this is what John Tortorella, one of his, maybe his first commandment, is the blue paint. He doesn't say the blue paint enough in his mind to his team, whether defending or getting the puck there on offense. He wants to live there. Here come the Devils now. Good stick play there by Braun. He's had a good first period. Watch out. Here come the Flyers with numbers. Konechny over to Hayes. Can't get it there. And now back come the Devils. Time winding down. 2-on-1. The dangerous Jack Hughes. Oh, high and wide. Pass Hart. And back come the Flyers trying to beat the buzzer. Konechny over the line. One more shot. It's blocked. And there's the horn from an eventful and entertaining first period. So it's first career goal, Alexander Holtz, and the first one in a while for Wade Allison, Steve Levy, and Kevin Weeks.
All right, Butchie, thanks very much. Coming up on the Lexus First Intermission Report, I'll ask Weeksy if that was, in fact, John Tortorella hockey, or at least 20 minutes of it. There are stars everywhere on a 10-game slate in the NHL. We'll show you around the league next.
ESPN Plus Hockey Night presented by New Amsterdam Vodka. Philadelphia. After 20 minutes, the first 20 minutes of the John Tortorella coached Flyers, it's 1-1. Now time for tonight's game recap brought to you by Progressive. Raymond Ferraro, break down the first 20 for me.
Pretty good period for the Flyers. I thought the Devils picked up the majority of their shots late in the period, but early on I was really impressed that the Flyers were able to play up on their toes. There was a little bit of this, a lot of energy for John Tortorella and these new Flyers. First game in particular at home, the Devils banged up a little bit, but they get the game's first goal, and it's Alexander Holtz's first in his career. He sneaks this one through Carter Hart. Moments later, a long wrist shot that Mackenzie Blackwood should hold hits him in the chest, and Wade Allison, his fifth NHL goal, and it's 1-1.
And the second period underway in Philadelphia as the Flyers' first 20. There was pushing and shoving. Almost a couple of fights, 13 block shots, which is what you expect from a Tortorella coach team. Now the Devils. Disappointing power play in the first period, Ray. I got to think they can't be happy at all with their setup and their production.
No, I didn't like it at all. And what I'm seeing here now is they're out 4-on-4, and they got Hughes and Brad out here together. And they want to strike a little quicker. Their power play was stagnant and really lacked the one shooter I thought that they needed on the Hughes setup in particular.
Hughes turnover, then Braun gets it right back, and here comes Konechny. 4-on-4, as Ray mentioned. Sanheim just signed a big contract before the game. 8 years, $6.25 million for the 26-year-old defenseman.
An identical deal to Mackenzie Weegar's contract in Calgary. Weegar went up there in the Tkachuk trade, and for the two defensemen, 50 million big ones for them for the next 8 years.
4-on-4 for 15 more seconds. Provorov, who played a lot of time killing those three penalties in the first period. Tatar back to the point. Doug Hamilton has some room. Shot saved by Hart. Rebound. Tatar can't quite get it. And Kevin Hayes collects. Hayes, who killed some penalties there in the first period as well, wants the puck. Provorov didn't like what he had, so he'll wait, extend it across. Zamula softly dumps it towards the zone. This will go right on Carter Hart, so it's no icing. Pressure forces the faceoff from Igor Sharangovic. Emily Kaplan is reporting for us tonight.
Guys, now we have a missing player on the Flyers lineup. Owen Tippett has not returned in the second period. Waiting word from the Flyers if he's being evaluated or maybe just an equipment issue.
That was the collision there, whether it was his head or his knee. You couldn't tell. Sometimes those hits hurt the knee. Sometimes they hit the head. You see, it kind of went down for a second.
Yeah, interesting. Both of them injured on the play. And Palat left with about 20 seconds left. He's back on the Devils bench. And as we just find out from Emily, Owen Tippett, who the Flyers feel came into camp a little quicker, a little more determined this year. He's back in the Flyers locker room.
There's Andre Palat, the 31-year-old Czech, two-time Stanley Cup champion.
18 goals last year, 11 in the playoffs.
That's right. Game 629 in his NHL career. Brought here to bring this team to the next level. Bratt. Bad angle shot actually went off of Holla. Goes in the corner. Sharangovic trying to feed Holla. Can't quite get it to him. Right point. Fight along the Devils bench. The puck ends up in the Devils bench. Emily, you have more on Andre Palat?
I do. When I talked to Tom Fitzgerald, the GM of the Devils, I said, how much was winning pedigree part of the reason you signed it? He said, that is the number one factor. He's a winner, but he understands details. He understands the commitment of playing without the puck, how to consistently play to our structure, and all of our players need to follow his lead.
Yeah, 0.67. points per game in the regular season. The last three playoffs, that bumped up to 0.73. Players' production does not usually increase in the postseason, Ray.
No, it doesn't.
But it does for him.
Yeah, he just had a way. Last year he was money, and what a great quote. In Tampa, they had 20 kids around the team here. They got a players that are 20 years old. What a great line.
Icing on the Flyers. Faceoff comes back to the other end. And some bad news for you, Ray. Last night, Connor McDavid, 11th career hat trick on opening night. He passes you on the all-time hat trick list. You had 10 in your great NHL career. Another player goes by you, Ray.
Yeah, he had talked about it being a career milestone for him, one of his hopes and dreams.
Yep, he did it. Took him a long time, though. It took him hundreds of games.
Yes, he's gonna lap the field. How about that? 4 points last night for McDavid. He and Draisaitl lead the comeback. 3-3 against Vancouver. They win 5-3. Crosby's got a couple of points in the first period today. David Pastrnak had 4 points. David Krejci had a couple of goals. Like, man, there's some good nights to start the season.
Penguins up 3-0 on the Arizona Coyotes after one.
What do you think that goal differential is going to be in Arizona this year?
Tough to start the season on all those road games. We'll have their first game at Arizona State here on ESPN Plus. I'll be there in a couple of weeks to see how that looks and feels to have an NHL team play in a rink with less than 5,000 fans. And here we go again. Scrums aplenty for these Flyer fans. These fans grew up with this kind of stuff. It hasn't been around the last couple of years, but that's why you bring Torts in. He demands that his players get to the blue paint on offense. That'll cause pushing and shoving. He demands his players defend at the other end.
That Konechny's going hard to the paint, and it's Brendan Smith's job to keep him out of there.
Yep.
So that's actually what both teams would like to see from their players is there's a loose puck or it's not quite covered. You want Konechny getting to the front of the net. And now Smith's job is to keep him out of there, and he does his job too. And he used to come into Philly here, well, in the old building, it felt like the roof was on top of your head, and there was no whistle without one of those. It was not a very comfortable place to be.
Fourth line against fourth line. Lazinski can't quite get the draw, and the Devils will have time to clear. Long pass up, tip that won't be icing. As McLeod tipped it just over the red line. Miles Wood, aggressive forechecker, big body, fast skater, number 44. Goes back to the point to Graves. Looking for a shooting lane, goes towards the point, never gets there. Lots of bodies in front of Carter Hart. Wood, Graves, wrist shot, saved by Hart. Saw that all the way, and Delorier chases it down. He'll chip it off the glass and out.
That's really good work by the Flyers' defense, Zamula and Sealer. They keep the front clear, and so Hart gets a 50-foot look at a shot, and he stops it. One of the things John Tortorella talked about today is we got to give our goalie a chance to be good.
Matthews and Ovechkin going head-to-head tonight. We'll have a studio update from that game with Arda on the next whistle. Wonder who scored there. Siegenthaler. Sturdy defenseman up the wall, past Mercer. Here's Provorov. What's his ceiling on this team, coached by John Tortorella? That's a guy they want to see maybe take another step. Icing waved off. Good hustle there by Frost as Jack Hughes takes it. Silky through the neutral zone. Enters a zone. Dancing between two Flyers D. Knocked down by Provorov, who takes the puck away and starts the breakout. Allison, nice play. Frost, wheel shot, saved by Blackwood. Rebound in front. Flyers couldn't take advantage of it.
I've liked Allison here. First 25 minutes of the game, he's got the goal, but he's been heavy on the puck, and there gets another scoring chance.
Aggressive forecheck. Hamilton takes down his man, but here's Palat back on the ice, gets hit hard, and he doesn't like that at all. That looked like he came pretty high, building a fence as Konechny came after him. Konechny chasing his, checking his face for blood. He'll go chase after that puck now. Avoids the hit from Siegenthaler. Barry in front, tipped, oh, just wide. Good chance in front there. And Cates had a shot and a penalty coming up on the Devils now. So Konechny was hit a couple of times. Doug Hamilton will go to the box, and the Flyers will go on the power play.
Now there's Konechny again, back-to-back shifts around the paint. He scrums up with Palat on the wall, and instead of standing there,
New Jersey number seven, 2 minute minor penalty, interference.
He gets himself to the front of the net, and the deflection just goes wide in the front of the net by Cates, and then Dougie Hamilton's a little bit late. Looks like he's almost trying to avoid him. He ends up running Konechny into his goaltender, Blackwood, and the Flyers will get their second power play of the game here, tied at one.
Kevin Hayes will take the draw. Konechny's back out there. James Van Riemsdyk as well, right now on the right point. He'll eventually move down closer to the net. Farabee's also out there. D'Angelo's the lone defenseman. Battle along the wall. These are the battles that John Tortorella wants to win. It's three on three, squirts out. Van Riemsdyk uses that long reach to keep it alive around Bastion, but then the clear by the Devils.
John, you said it's three on three in the corner. That's no good by the Flyers. If it's three on three, you need a fourth man there. You've got the extra man, use it to get the puck first so you can get set up.
Farabee knocked down, comes to Hayes. Going to try to get it back to the point to D'Angelo. Can't do it, but now it does get there, courtesy of Van Riemsdyk. Farabee, he's got a good shot from distance. 86. Van Riemsdyk, Konechny will throw it along the wall. Devils doing a good job keeping the puck to the outside for now, and a good clear there by Marino, who's played well tonight, Ray. Skating by you right now. They got him from Pittsburgh, and he's played a lot of minutes in the first period. Most shifts by a Devils player in the first period, Marino.
Yeah, the Devils talked about how they've really liked how he's come in and played very well. He kind of lost his way a little bit in Pittsburgh after a good early first rookie season there, but they picked him up in the trade for Ty Smith and a draft pick, and he's really given them another NHL-ready defenseman to move the puck simply out of their zone.
Second unit on for the Flyers. Allison's out there. Frost will get some time as well, but that's going to be icing on the power play by the Flyers. Neither power play has looked very impressive tonight.
Now, one of the other things that John Tortorella talked about today is, as we keep talking about how they want this foundation of hard work and grit and, you know, to be physical, he said, we need skill. You cannot win in this league without skill. The problem the Flyers have is they don't have enough of it. So they hope to score by committee. They don't have game breakers. They don't have a Jack Hughes. You've got to find a way to score, and it's where you notice it is on the power play. You just don't have playmakers, although they are missing some people that could help their power play. John Couturier is still out of the lineup, and they hope for him in a little bit of time. Bobby Brink's a young kid that they feel can help, and of course, Cam Atkinson, their leading goal scorer, is not in the lineup tonight either.
So the Devils doing a good job killing this penalty. Under 10 seconds to go. One more quick rush for the Flyers. Maybe they can create some pressure as Doug Hamilton comes back into the play. Konechny has it. Here comes Dougie Hamilton out of the box. And he's working on offense with Hughes. Hughes with speed. Jack Hughes waits, finds a man, shot, Smith's save in front. Golden opportunity, and back come the Flyers the other way. Konechny, shot, save by Blackwood.
Jack Hughes gets a 2-on-1. Goes across to Brendan Smith. Smith airmails this over top of Carter Hart. And then the puck turns over, and Travis Konechny tries the 5-hole on Blackwood. He swallows it up.
Art Ocal with a studio update for you. Game between the Leafs and the Capitals. You can catch on NHL Power Play here on ESPN+. Nick Dowd made it 1-1. That's Marcus Johansson, the former Devil, getting the lead for the Capitals. How about Jason Robertson, fresh new contract in hand? It'll be the Stars and the Predators at Bridgestone Arena, 8:30 p.m. Eastern on ESPN+. Bucci.
Thank you, Arda. 13:02 to go here. John Butchergrass, Ray Ferraro, Emily Kaplan, of course, Dave Jackson, former NHL referee, our NHL rules expert, always on call if we need him. Shot high and wide of Mackenzie Blackwood. And this 1-1 game in Philadelphia. Graves, nice pressure by Kevin Hayes. Konechny knocked down by Graves. Play continues. McLeod uses his body nicely, makes a real good pass to Tatar as the Devils break out. In the zone, onside. Bouncing towards Tatar. Chipped in the corner by Boqvist. Jesper Boqvist. Nice move by Searson, but Konechny steals. Could be a 2-on-1 with Hayes and Konechny. Hayes with Konechny. Curl shot saved by Blackwood. Hayes has it back behind the net. So another two. We've had multiple odd man rushes in this period now. Big hip check. Hayes in front. Skate saved by Blackwood and cleared out towards Holtz, who's running it down. Number 10, who got his first NHL goal in this game. And here's D'Angelo quickly up to Farabee, and back come the Flyers now. Open in front. Good stick work by Bren Smith. As Noah Cates was charging the net, number 49. Good stick play by Cates there to get that puck back, and goes to Farabee. Farabee goes behind the net to D'Angelo, the defenseman. He'll send it right back. As the Flyers with some pressure now. D'Angelo walking the line, can't find a lane. Cates lets it go, then goes and gets it. Sealed behind the net by Smith. Holtz has some numbers. He's out there now with Hughes. Hughes, soft little chip pass towards Palat. Taken there by Provorov. And he'll quickly move it up the wall. Hayden Hodgson out there. Number 42. Some line shifting going on now by both teams. Here's Hughes, throws it across, quickly shot, saved by Hart. Nice pass by Hughes over to Dawson Mercer. Looked like he didn't get a lot on that shot, but a good push off by Carter Hart to get squared up.
Really good track from Hart as he's got to go from his left across the ice to the right. And then when Hughes throws it across the ice, he's got to go back again. Watch Jack Hughes here, comes across the blue line to pick this puck up. His vision as he's going to his left, he already knows that Dawson Mercer's on his right. This is a great feather pass. It goes over Provorov's stick, and Hart has to track that left to right and back the other way to make an excellent save on Mercer's bid. That's his best tonight.
Holla, Sharon Govich, and Brad out there now. Hamilton the slap shot. He's out there with Siegenthaler. Net is off. Whistle blows.
Eric Holla, one of the veterans brought in by Tom Fitzgerald in the offseason, and they had gone after Johnny Gaudreau, thought that they had an opportunity, didn't get Gaudreau. They're hoping for a better year, a healthier year out of Dougie Hamilton. They bring in Palat, and they're hoping that they're going to be able to help make a jump into a position to compete for a playoff spot. It's going to be hard. Those young teams, Detroit, Buffalo, Ottawa, Jersey, I think they're still kind of a year away from being real playoff contenders, because it's just so difficult to make up so many points.
Morgan Frost was in all alone, but he couldn't handle the pass. He would have had a point-blank opportunity. Brad out there now, battling at the blue line. Knocked out in front. Holla shot into the glove of Carter Hart. Follow the NHL on social media for behind-the-scenes coverage of the biggest moments, original content with your favorite players, and highlights from the best plays in hockey.
Now Hart settling in after giving up the Holtz goal, which he most certainly would like a redo on, but he's been excellent since then.
Shot Bastion, save again by Carter Hart, the 24-year-old. This is his 140th start. Of course, he had that good playoff run back in 1920, Ray, 926 save percentage. But since then, the last couple of years, it's been a little rough. But, of course, the team around him is tough. Probably the worst situation a young goalie could be in the last couple of years.
I think almost everything most of us like to be boiled down to one reason. Factually, it's never just one thing. Hart's had some injuries. The team's not been as good. I think he's gotten to the point where he's lost his confidence a bit, and it's almost like you try to stop two shots instead of one. And so all those things kind of compact onto a goaltender, and you lose your way. And they need him to be much better.
Good hits here on this game. Fourth line out there for the Devils. McLeod, Bastion, and Wood. Bodies on the floor all night long here. It's been a pretty physical game, in your face a bit. Just the two goals so far. And Delorier will get it out of there. Good job by Graves to keep that gap closed. He's hit hard by Delorier. McLeod comes over and hits Delorier. He'll fight anything that moves tonight. Hayes off the bench. Cycles down. And here come the Devils as Delorier will look to change. Graves. Shot blocked. A lot of blocked shots by the Flyers tonight in this game. ...17 shots for New Jersey, just 12 for Philadelphia. Nice play by Kevin Hayes. Ripped it, score! to the net. 2-1 Philadelphia.
Goals for Travis Konecny in a rather difficult season. This kid should be a 20-plus goal scorer all the time. He's got such a good release. We've seen him nosing around the front of the net. Look at the pinch by Provorov to keep that play alive. He squeezes up on the Devils forward right at the red line, and as he closes that playoff, it's Thomas Tatar. He kicks it up to Kevin Hayes, who makes that little sweet dish to Travis Konecny. His shot eludes Brendan Smith. It goes over the glove of Mackenzie Blackwood, and the Flyers have a 2-1 lead.
Little different offseason for Konecny. He never paid much attention to analytics, but this year he sat down with people from the Flyers front office to talk about when he's had the most success, where it's come from. Little self-reminders, little focuses to be in the right spot at the right time, and right there certainly was the right spot at the right time as he takes the feed from Hayes. Give Provorov an assist as well, and the Flyers have a 2-1 opportunistic lead. See if that jumps some energy into them. Lozinski throws it across. Out there with Van Riemsdyk and Frost. In front, shot, score! Morgan Frost! 3-1 Philadelphia. ...23-year-old Morgan Frost was a first-rounder in 2017. He's out of his entry-level contract. He's had a disappointing start to his NHL career. Yet he takes a one-year, $800,000 contract. JVR with the puck goes below the goal line. This is a sweet feed from Lozinski. Right out top, and as Palat doesn't squeeze Morgan Frost, he's got his first of the year. And quickly, two goals, and it's 3-1.
Two goals in 23 seconds. And that's the first career point for Tanner Lozinski on that assist.
In front, Cates! Scooped up by Blackwood.
Tanner Lozinski played 4 years at Ohio State, 25 years old. He made the nice dish from behind the net. Just his seventh NHL game for number 58, and he fed number 48.
After Travis Konecny makes it 2-1. Moments later, Morgan Frost makes it 3-1, and the Flyers lead by two.
Getting gritty with it in Philadelphia. Emily Kaplan's with the other coach, Lindy Ruff.
Where did you notice the defensive breakdown on that last goal?
Well, you know, I think the mistake was up by the blue line. We got on the wrong side of the puck. I think if you look at both goals, you know, we're on the wrong side of the puck. They got an opportunity. We got to play better away from the puck.
What does your team need to do to get back in this?
Well, we need to finish our opportunities. We've had some really good looks, two-on-ones that we haven't finished. I think we get the opportunities. We've got to find it back in the net.
Thanks, Lindy.
So the Flyers are alive, up 3-1 here in Philadelphia.
That's a good point from Lindy Ruff. His both goals, he said, talks about the players ending up on the wrong side of the puck. And when we talked this morning to him, and he was saying, you know, we got to give up less goals. Here they are. They've given up three again here in game one. And it's just too hard night after night to score four goals to win. So those two mistakes have changed the entire complexion of how the Devils have to play the last 28 minutes to try and climb back into this.
Yeah, three goals on only 15 shots for the Flyers. How's your save percentage now? So the Devils got to go to work. They got plenty of time to do it, almost half a game. We'll see if Lindy Ruff does anything with the Lions. Maybe give that guy some first power play looks.
We'll get another couple. We'll get a look at the goals here. You see Graves pinches in the middle. Now, Tatar's got to be inside of Konecny. When he's not, Smith isn't up far enough, so the shot's clean and it's into the net. And you've got John Marino standing at the goal line. He's checking air. There's nobody there. JVR's taken behind the net. Marino has to turn, look off his shoulder to deny that pass. He can't get there quick enough. Palat can't get there quick enough, and Morgan Frost has it on the board is for his first of the season.
Delorier almost with a hold there. Play continues. Delorier has it back.
But Graves has it, and here come the Devils now. John Tortorella pretty much rolling the entire bench here as an icing is called.
NHLShop.com, the official online store of the NHL and the world's largest selection of officially licensed NHL fan gear. Shop now and get today's special offer. NHLShop.com, a Fanatics experience.
Imposter gritty. You could use some NyQuil or something, I think. That's a little under the weather.
How many gritty costumes for Halloween do you think are out there?
Probably really big early on, year one and two for sure. Flyers looking to keep the pressure on. They get jump in their step. Allison back to Sanheim. Point blank. Shot it wide. Didn't have control of it. Allison battles it again with Boqvist. As the Devils on their heels right now in Philadelphia. Down 3-1 in their first game of the season. Again, all that emerging young talent. And they go out and give the big bucks to Palat. Bring in Marino as well. But again, the big worry for this organization was what would be the play between the pipes. Talked about it before the game with
Luck out.
Holtz
was lucky that was Kevin Hayes and not Delorier coming in.
It would have been the 10th row. Hayes, what a move. Sauces it over. Comes back to D'Angelo. Quick shot deflected high into the netting by Holtz.
So with Mackenzie Blackwood giving up 3 goals and 15 shots, New Jersey is hoping to have a goaltending tandem, a two-goaltender system. There's Vitek Vanacek, who came from the Washington Capitals. He traded a second and a third for him. They signed him to a 3-year contract. He's had an excellent camp. And so I don't think the Devils really have a particular favorite as to who they hope is the number one. They just hope somebody takes the mantle.
Again, 7 goaltenders got into game action for the Devils last season. Team save percentage, .881. Jonathan Bernier led the way, the only goalie over .900 save percentage. Blackwood, Dawes, John Gillies, Andrew Hammond, Akira Schmid, hello, Scott Wedgwood. They all posted the worst 5-on-5 save percentage in the NHL. They bring Blackwood back, and as Ray mentioned, they trade to try to get some stability in net. Maybe Vanacek be that answer.
Vanacek's goaltending partner, Ilya Samsonov, went to Toronto, and
he's making a chance too.
Yeah, he's making his first start tonight as the Leafs are trailing after one period against his former team, the Caps.
6.5 to go here in the first.
I don't know that there could be a better script so far for the Flyers. I mean, they've defended well. They haven't been in their zone a lot. They've taken 3 penalties that have cost them zone time, but they scored the 2 goals in 23 seconds, and I think it's been a really nice start on home ice for them.
Well, John Tortorella was hired. Some really in-your-face quotes from Torts. As far as the room, I have major concerns about the room. I have concerns about what's going on in there. Before we step on the ice, situations and standards and accountability in the room is forefront. So he kind of set the tone right away without even being, you know, around very long. I can sense the locker room's a bit splintered. It's not all together, Torts said. That's my number one goal right now. We can't do anything right on the ice unless we're together in that locker room, and that's a very important part of the first piece of work I need to do, is to get everybody to believe that we're together.
A lot of coaches come into a new spot, and they've got to set the tone. They've got to earn the players' respect, or they've got to earn their ear. John doesn't have to earn it. When he comes in, I can guarantee you the Flyer players started to work harder in the summer. They're like, we better get going.
No doubt. Dan Riemsdyk in front, looking for Frost, can't connect. Back to the point, Sanheim. Knocked out, and here comes Brett. It's been a little quiet so far in this game. Here's Holla. Softly, almost missed by Hart. Back to Hamilton, and the Devils are set up. Siegenthaler looking for a lane. He'll throw it towards the net. Hamilton with the aggressive pinch down 3-1. Quick shot. Short side. Comes back to the left point, and Siegenthaler. And he'll keep it in.
good play by Braun there. Braun's had a good game. He hit the post early and uses his big body there. Remember, Braun was on the team last year. They trade him to New York for a third rounder, then sign him right back again. As Brat has a long distance shot right to the logo of Carter Hart. 3-1, late second in Philly. Back in Philadelphia, Emily Kaplan with us with the latest on Joe Farabee's summer. Emily.
Yeah, he's playing today after becoming the third player in NHL history to get artificial disc replacement surgery. That's a surgery that Jack Eichel fought for, then Tyler Johnson got it. What's interesting, when I caught up with Joel before the game, is he told me his doctors didn't even recommend or even offer fusion as an option. He said, this is the new trend. He did catch up with Eichel, who said, I was a little nervous to get hit in my first game, but after that, it's on. Real is a game changer. Meanwhile, Farabee's line mate Owen Tippett is being evaluated for an upper body injury, I am told, so unclear he's going to return to this game. Joel told me, I haven't seen a guy get faster summer over summer than Owen did. He's playing with so much speed these days.
Farabee had that surgery June the 24th. Here he is on open night, off the post and out. Severson hit the inside of the left post. Almost, it might have even grazed the right post. So close to making it a one-goal game for the Devils. That's two posts for the Flyers and one for the Devils in this game. Graves has room. Wrist shot. Nice stick work there by Konechny. Loose in front, trying to stuff it home. The helmet comes off of Tatar. And the whistle blows as the Flyers clear the blue paint. Get out.
Tatar was pretty hot with Scott Laughton, and he went right back at him behind the net. A puck that hit the goal post, then as the play stays in the zone, a wild scramble around the front of the net. And the Flyers are able to keep this just outside the goal line. Face-off scrum, and the Devils come out with the puck. Severson's shot is deflected off the near post from Boqvist, and then Graves will get this clean look. His shot goes to Tatar. Oh, what a save by Provorov.
Yes, kick screen hockey save.
And then as you see Laughton take the helmet off Tatar's dome, they have some words behind the net. So Hart, a little bit of help from his friends. As Provorov, who's got an assist this period, makes a goal-saving save as well.
Provorov's been strong in this game tonight, killing penalties, blocking shots right there. He's taken 18 shifts. On his way to a 20-minute night plus for the Flyers on their blue line, up 3-1. Getting outshot 22-15. But three of the 15 have gotten by Mackenzie Blackwood. Along the wall, Severson keeps in a bouncing puck. Nice play. Gets it back. Severson walks in. Extra pass Graves. Shot high and wide off the glass. Might have hit a shoulder of Hart. And here comes Farabee. Has a man, Allison, towards the net. Graves will backhand shovel it out. Allison back in the zone. Nice soft pass in front. Hayes turning, looking. Defended there hard by McLeod. McLeod gets it back. Protects. Goes back to Severson. The Devils will regroup behind their own net. Here comes Nathan Bastian. Out there with McLeod and Miles Wood, the fourth line of the Devils. McLeod. Wood will try to race it down, use that big body on Morgan Frost. Hear the communication from our official tonight. Keep it moving, boys. Dougie Hamilton goes in front. Wood knocked down. The puck might have knocked him down as well. And here come the Flyers with some numbers. To the net goes Frost. Delorier shot into the glove of Mackenzie Blackwood. Let's go back to Arno Cal with an update.
Butchie, thank you very much. Taking you to the New York Rangers and Minnesota Wild. Picking it up at 1-0. It'll be Adam Fox from Alexi Lafreniere and Artemi Panarin. There's the pass. There's the goal. It's now 3-0. Panarin has a goal and two assists, including that third one, Butchie.
The always entertaining Nick Delorier, 31 years old. This is game 507 in his NHL career. His fifth team, Buffalo, Montreal,
Anaheim, a few with Minnesota last year towards their playoff push. Now he signs a nice four-year contract with the Flyers for $1.75 million. As a 31-year-old, he will take that.
Yeah, he doesn't play an easy game. It's a physical, demanding, hard role to play. There's just not a lot of players that play the style DeLaurier does anymore.
And he's good for this city, good for these Flyer fans. They're going to like 44. He'll be one of the more popular players on this team this year. Overall, John Tortorella, again, they're not generating a lot of shots, but the pace has been pretty good. The compete certainly has been there.
But don't you think, Butch, that goes a little bit hand-in-hand with what he said. We miss the skill.
That's
we
right.
need the skill.
Yep.
The work is non-negotiable. They've worked hard. It's just making some plays to create a little more time with the puck is part of the next step.
And those opportunities tonight, they've taken advantage of a couple defensive breakdowns from New Jersey. They've had opportunities in high-danger areas, and they've finished with good shots. Frost rips it. Konechny ripped it.
And the Devils, lots of chances,
but
lots of zone time, lots of puck possession. In my mind, too much outside the dots.
Yeah.
Not enough into the middle guts of the ice in the offensive zone, and just hard to score that way. Goalies are too good.
Here comes Mercer, slaps it, saved by Hart. And like you said, Ray, they kind of lack that power hitter. Like they're like a baseball team without a 3-4 hitter, a guy that can score from distance, who pulverizes the puck. And so you really got to work for everything.
Well, if you look at the way the best players on their team, Hughes and Hischier, are more facilitators, I would say, than goal scorers, although Jack Hughes had 26 goals in a very short season last year. Bratt is more of a facilitator than a finisher. You need a one-shot score. It's okay if the guy's one trick is to score goals.
Yeah.
That's okay. I think too often we get all focused in. We need a 200-foot player. Great. Find me someone else to check. I need somebody to score eventually.
Here comes Hughes with speed. Jack Hughes in alone. Walk saved by Carter Hart. His best of the night. Jack Hughes on the off wing with speed. And 79 comes up big.
One of the more important Flyers after a year that didn't go so well for Carter Hart. He gave up the Alexander Holtz goal through his arm and leg, but since then he's been excellent. He's been solid for the most part in that once he makes the save, there hasn't been a lot of loose stuff around. And then here's his last stop as Hughes gets outside the Flyer defense. Little help from Braun, but Hart goes left to right to get his pad flat to make the save.
Under two to go here in the second period. 24 shots now for the Devils. 16 for the Flyers. Carter Hart, that shot starts to creep up. You can see his last two seasons, sub 900. You're not going to win hockey games anymore, especially as scoring has gone up. But tonight, 23 of 24. And again, he's going to eventually see well over 30, so we'll see where he stands at night's end. Big Foo Fighters fan is Carter Hart. Got the fresh paint job this year with Dave Grohl and, of course, the late Taylor Hawkins on the right side of the mask. And he's been coming through tonight, Carter Hart. Hughes is back out there again, goes down. There's Palat, comes back to Mercer to Hughes. So elusive, trying to get around Provorov. Good job by Provorov, good support by Palat. He walks into the dangerous area, makes a nice pass to Severson. One more pass in front, open net. Severson knocks it in front, covered up by Hart, gets the whistle. Severson had Jack Hughes for a moment, wide open for a tap-in empty net goal, but couldn't get the puck to him.
Possession starts high with Hughes, and once Palat and Severson get involved, Mercer's got post position. He's right on top of the crease. As soon as that puck went into Hughes, everybody just swallowed up that area. Maybe Severson's better to shoot that with the positioning of Mercer in front of the net.
1:11 to go in the second. Devils looking for that late second period goal. Of course, the Flyers looking to prevent that and go to the room with a two-goal lead. Lawton drops it back nicely to Hayes, who's able to get it out and bunted forward by Konechny. Under a minute to go now. Aggressive forecheck by Konechny all over the ice. In the zone now with some numbers. One-timer, Holtz. Good stick work, tip wide. The rookie with the first of his career, the first of the year tonight for the Devils. Maybe he's one of those guys we could see on that power play who can provide a one-time bomb from that off-wing position. Offside at the line.
Well, tied 1-1 after one period. The 23 seconds in the middle part of this period led to goals by Travis Konechny and Morgan Frost. And Philly in good shape here to run this period down and head home after 40 minutes with a two-goal lead. Then you just have to defend the third, but a pretty solid home opener for them thus far.
Miles Wood will try to take that bouncy puck. He's got good wheels in front. Shot saved by Hart into the glove. Save on McLeod. Penalty coming up, though, a hooking penalty. Going to be on the Flyers, so the Devils a little short 11.5-second power play here in the second, and it'll begin the third if they don't score.
New Jersey number 44, 2 minutes for hooking.
I'm sorry, it's on the Devils, Raymond.
Yeah, so Wood's trying to drive up the ice, and he's going to get called for the hook as McLeod, who can really go, is chasing this. There's the hook, as you see the stick of Woods goes through the hands and body of Justin Braun. So the Flyers, who have the game's only power, the Flyers get their third power play. The Devils have the game's only power play goal, but the Flyers with a crack at it here. Maybe a face-off and a quick shot.
What we'll try for. Face-off. Drop right, won by McLeod. He's an excellent faceoff guy, close to 60% last year. Second period winding down, looking for a shot at the buzzer. Marino will keep it right there, chase it down, that'll do it. So the Flyers will begin the third period with a two-goal lead and a power play. The Devils outshoot Philly 15-8 in the second, but it's the Flyers with a two-goal lead. Steve Levy and cool Papa Bell, Kevin Weeks.
All right, Pucci, thanks. He is cool, and the studio is really cold. Coming up, the Discover Second Intermission Report. We will travel the National Hockey League. All the great stars playing tonight. And more on the feisty Flyers out front.
So all the little things, not winning and losing, not the big body checks, all the little things of how hard we're going to be to play against. That's who we're going to be.
That was before the game, and excuse my bellicosity. The Flyers have come out, and they put bodies on the floor. They protected the paint. They've scored near the paint, and they finished their opportunities. Konechny and Frost, the last two, sniping from close range and giving the Flyers a 3-1 lead. And meanwhile, Provorov and the defense protecting the defensive blue paint. ESPN Plus Hockey Night presented by New Amsterdam Vodka. And the Flyers will begin this third period with a 3-1 lead and on the power play. John Butchergoss alongside Ray Ferraro, who's down between the benches. And, well, some early season issues for the Devils, Ray. Their power play has not looked good. And here in game number one, they're down 3-1 entering the third.
That sounds like a little bit of the record from last year. I mean, if they're going to get back into this game, they got to kill this penalty, of course, down a couple. But I think they need to get themselves on the inside of the game. They've had enough chances, yeah, but you have to make it a little harder than it's been for the Flyers and for Carter Hart. They've had too much of their offensive push from outside the dots. It's just not going to be successful that way.
Big moment in the game for the Flyers here if they can get one on the power play and take a three-goal lead here in the third. Farabee.
Early power plays are hard, but you're not warmed up. You're not quite as sharp, and the penalty killers just have to shoot it down the ice.
Good point. Like this. Here they come the other way, shorthanded. Holla. Sharon Govich, but Konechny takes it and quickly thinks offense. They got numbers. Here comes Farabee. Gives it to Konechny. And alone, Konechny saved by Blackwood.
That's a big one. He had room.
right in Ray's vision between the benches coming down that right wing. But the Flyers are set up. Plenty of time. Save Van Riemsdyk. Another save by Blackwood. Hayes has it. Back to the point. D'Angelo. Kevin Hayes, and he played catch. Farabee's open. He likes to step in and shoot like that. Deflected. Konechny! Extra pass down low to Van Riemsdyk. Crowd said, shoot that between the hash marks. Now he does! Off the post! Yo, ding dong! Ding dong, yo, for the third time tonight for the Flyers. D'Angelo. Over to Farabee. That's kind of his spot right there to step in and shoot. Konechny again! Score! Three for a dollar! Travis Konechny on the power play makes it 4-1.
A goal in the second period. Now Konechny's going to get a clean look in on the power play. And Blackwood beats him with the right pad stop. But the Flyers regain possession. They work the puck into the slot. Konechny rings one off the right goal post. The puck still stays in the Flyers' hands. And from the slot, Konechny one times a Kevin Hayes pass. And the Flyers lead 4-1.
And now the Devils are in a big hole here in their opening game of the season. Down 4-1. Hughes out there now with Bratt and Palat. Travis Konechny, one of those energizing players the Flyers need. Turnovers open in front is Cates. Can't get it by the long reach of Graves. And the Devils got to find their game quickly. Hughes makes a nice play to get it, throws it in front, looking for Palat, but covered well by Sanheim. Skated out of there by Lozinski. Make that Wade Allison, number 57. Allison, Lawton, Frost. Good play by Sanheim to wheel away. Nice pass up to Frost, try to leave it there. But the skating Lozinski, who's out there now, number 58. Flyers are energized from the get-go. They have taken the words from their coach, and for now, at least one night, they have delivered, doing all those little things. Still getting outshot 25-20, but Carter Hart's been solid in net, and again, they've taken advantage of their opportunities. Getting some good point-blank chances on Mackenzie Blackwood. And Travis Konechny led the Flyers in scoring last year. He's 25 years old. This is game 429, so he's been in the league for a while. He's got experience at a good young age, so he can combine that experience, Ray, with still youthful energy.
His game is about energy. When I think of Konechny, I have a little bit of a picture of Brendan Gallagher in Montreal, always in motion. Always an agitating force by the way he plays. Last year, alongside of the 16 goals, which was a little low for him, he had 220 shots. He's not scared to shoot it. And we saw in that last shift, he shot it four times before eventually it worked its way into the net for his second of the game.
Here he is again, going for the hat trick. Konechny, nice pass down low, shot saved by Blackwood.
He was staring at Justin Braun as he came over the top, basically like a quarterback telling his receiver, go, like get moving. And finally Braun decided to go, and then Konechny laid that nice little pass across. That's a good scoring chance for Braun, who hit the post in the first, has a good chance here in the third.
He saw to the left of Blackwood. Lawton takes that face off, but won by the Devils and chipped out by Bratt. Will not go far enough for icing. Braun takes a hit. Back in front, Palat, who delivered that hit, took the feed from Hughes but couldn't quite handle it. One career hat trick for Travis Konechny, by the way. And there's the 26th shot by the Devils, gobbled up by Hart. Come on!
Travis Konecny's lone NHL hat trick back in January of 2021 against the Penguins. That's a good team to get a hat trick against.
They're all good to get a hat trick against.
First, well, you've had 10, so it was no big deal.
No, I guess my point is any of them are.
No, for sure. Siegenthaler. Nice little move. Still has it. Throws it behind the net. Comes to Hughes. Hughes throws it in front quickly. He's going to play a lot the rest of the way to try to get the Devils back in this game. That shot, another block by Provorov. And you know the Flyers want number 9 to be out there when 86 is out there for the Devils. Here's Hughes. Turns it over. But back comes Mercer now. Some numbers. Hughes. Shot deflected again into the netting. Faceoff will be in the Flyer end. It's a frustrating night for Jack Hughes.
Yeah, really not much going for him. He's had a couple of chances. Early 2-on-1 that he missed up high. A second one in the second period that he had, but the power play in the first period was not very dangerous. And of course, Hughes is going to run that power play. If it's going to be successful, lots is going to go through his hands.
Faceoff shot. Just by Hart as Holtz really wired that one. Number 10. He's the guy they want to shoot from that distance. He can rip it. Still has room to get stronger. He should only improve, which he's been doing.
Well, he's 20 years old, and yeah. I think a lot of times because he came at 18, you forget with these players, they're 18, 19 years old, and it's really difficult to be strong enough to play at the pace you have to play against guys that are 26 and 27 years old. Like, how are you? Just think, if you're in a puck battle against Sidney Crosby, how is he possibly going to win that? You're just not going to be strong enough.
Right.
And that's the patience and the development team to work with him, and that'll be the extra stuff, the extra work he's going to have to put in to be a legit NHLer. He's got his first. It's a good place to start.
Marino gets it back. Boquist. And no Nico Hischier for the Devils in this game. The hamstring just wasn't quite good enough to go today. It was close. Such an important part to this Devil balance. Gives them strength up the middle. Again, another player just keeps getting better as he's emerging into a prime-time NHL player. And that's what, you know, we talk about these teams, Ray, trying to make that move. You can't afford injuries because the depth's not there.
Right, and certainly, oh, here goes Hughes.
Here we go. Jack Hughes, shot saved by Hart. Another save by Hart as he gets Sharon Govitz, a guy who can shoot it and score it twice. Brad. The Devils thinking offense the rest of the way, just deflects wide on that one by Hart.
Well, there's Severson, the defenseman, back below the goal line. I mean, there's no point trying to defend anymore. You got to get a couple quick ones to see if you can get a chance to come back in this game.
Jack Hughes will be certainly double shifting here for the foreseeable future. Got some TV timeouts coming up. Certainly the Devils still have their own timeout as they try to get 3 goals here in the last 14 minutes. Here's Hughes again. Nice move around Van Riemsdyk. Enters the zone to Bratt. Bratt throws it across as a streaking Palat was there. But here come the Flyers now. They could get a 3-on-2 if they hurry. Just onside is Van Riemsdyk. Fishing shot. Kick save by Blackwood as Allison came down that right wing and got a shot off on goal. Frost has thrown his body around a couple times in this game. We didn't see that at all last year from number 48. He's also scored tonight. One of his better games as a pro, if not the best. Shot Zamula just high and wide, looking for his first NHL point. Lozinski behind them, who got his first NHL point tonight. Tanner Lozinski in his 7th NHL game. Comes back to Hayes. He's had the puck a lot tonight. Shot into the gut as there's Lozinski looking to get his first NHL goal.
Jack Hughes shakes his head after he makes a terrific play coming back, steal the puck, and turn it on for a 2-on-1 that Sharon Govich stopped by Carter Hart.
ESPN Plus Hockey Night is presented by New Amsterdam Vodka, the official vodka of the NHL. Drink responsibly. There's nothing better than being at ice level like Ray Ferraro. for the speed and sounds of the game. So what we're going to do now is we're going to tell Ray to shut up. I'm going to shut up. And we're going to call this The Rush. Enjoy the sights and sounds of the NHL. So the faceoff will come to the right of if, Blackwood.
If there's any play around the net where somebody's got possession, just listen to how much talking there is on the ice. As everybody's trying to be their partner's eyes because you can't see what's behind you, or if you're screened from another player, you're always trying to help out. There's more talk than you would think.
Noah Cates and Eric Halla on the faceoff. On the Flyers. This reminder, here's a look at some of the featured upcoming games on the NHL schedule. Lightning, Penguins in Pittsburgh, NHL Network. ESPN Plus game in where? Tampa, you got it. Next Tuesday, these Flyers are in Tampa. TNT doubleheader, Torts again in Florida against the Panthers. And then game two of that doubleheader, St. Louis at Seattle. Kraken losing in overtime to the Ducks last night, but they look good. Matty Beniers is a player. He's already.
I've got him in my top of class for Rookie of the Year. Yeah. I think he's going to play a lot. He's going to get a lot of points.
Yeah, no. Oliver Bjorkstrand got a wicked goal. He's an excellent player to add someone like him. McCann looks comfortable. He had a nice goal last night, so that team should be better in year two. They got a point last night in game number one. Here, the Devils are down 4-1. 11 minutes to go. There's still time. Need one soon here. Bratt towards the net wide.
Well, they got two shots on goal in this period, and they're going to have to spend some time down here. It can't just be one and out for them.
Outshot the Flyers in the first period and the second period. But just one by Carter Hart. Bratt. Walking towards the shot. Never got there. Hit Konechny. Severson rips it. Score! Twisted wrister. Damon Severson. He had 11 goals last year for the Devils, and that's his first this year, and they're right back in it with plenty of time to go.
Flyers have scored four straight goals. There's Severson's first as he gets Hart on the short side. I don't like this goal, John. I mean, look where Severson is. Hart's on his knees trying to find the puck. And as he does, he never gets quite square again. This hits right off the 7 and the 9 on his left arm. And if Hart's out or up, he makes that save. He's on his knees, and Severson gets him on the short side. And now the Devils have hope.
Real nice play by Bratt there. Good playmaker last year as Hart covers up. Of course, Jesper Bratt, career high in games played, goals, assist and points. He made the pass to 28 right there. Severson 28-year-old. His 567th NHL game. He's a UFA, Ray,
yeah,
this year.
Interesting year for him. You mentioned a UFA. If they can't come to some kind of deal or the deal's not there, will he be a Devil by the end of the year? I mean, there's already a lot of rumors around Damon Severson. He would be a sought-after player.
Big save by Hart on Mercer. Yeah, right-handed shot like that. Prime years of his life. I'm sure he's looking for a good number, but there's so much money you can pass out. But again, and Graves is also a UFA, so two vets. You do have young players coming, but these guys are playing now and ready to play. Devils are once again threatening. Shot blocked in front. Now the Flyers are on their heels. Hamilton shot just wide. Carter Hart's under siege.
This will be where you see if the Flyers just start to panic or whether they can settle in here for a shift or two, see if they can cut some of the momentum off. Hughes right back on the ice with Pratt.
So here comes the Pratt-Hughes combination. Hughes enters the zone, looking him go. A good stick by Van Riemsdyk and Braun, a couple tall players using that reach. So it's Pratt, Siegenthaler, and Hughes. Siegenthaler is a good shooter, number 17. So if Hughes finds him, he's the guy who can finish. Hughes back in the zone. Backhand pass across, chips softly towards the net and over the net. Hughes tries to get it, he does get it. Back to the point, Severson right back out there, fires, blocked. Shot wide. Siegenthaler had a chance, but he was just inches wide. Siegenthaler gets it back again. Shot wide in front. Brett fans on the shot as he tried a 360. Just too far for Hayes. Eight and a half to go coming up here in the third period. 4-2 game. Devils have time to get that third one and then think about the pull the goalie situation.
Yeah, you got 7 minutes before you really have to hit the panic button for New Jersey, but you need one, but in that 7 minutes.
And then we'll see how early we pull the goalie if you're still down two. We do that at 4 minutes. We do it 3.5. Another interesting thing to watch. One reason why goal scoring is going up because coaches are so more aggressive pulling their goalie with one and two goal leads. Boquist has it. Gets it to McLeod, who can skate. Stops. Trailer Hamilton. Nice pass over to Tatar. He wheels away. Falls down. Flyers can clear. Noah Cates gets it out, and he'll go and change. 29 shots, New Jersey. 24, Philadelphia. The Flyer try to regain some momentum. Good play by Provorov. Bodies off Mercer.
He's played a strong game tonight. Provorov has.
Saved a goal with a kick save in the blue paint. He's been out there in penalty kills. He's been in Jack Hughes' face a few times as well. Holla wheels around looking to make the pass to Palat. Ends up going deep, and they have the puck bat as Palat gets it, but Frost can't get it out. Graves will knock it behind the net. There's Provorov again. He'll play a lot down the stretch. Both benches will be shortened just a touch. One more TV timeout to go. To rest those defensemen, those top four D-men you want out if you're the Flyers. D'Angelo playing a lot tonight in his Flyers debut. Back on the Devils with some numbers. Pass in front. Pratt shot saved by Hart. Good save on a point-blank chance. Jesper Pratt had a chance. Graves tries to keep it in. Can't. A good veteran move by Van Riemsdyk to sprint to the red line and dump it in. He'll change. Fresh skaters for Philadelphia. As back comes Bratt. Dangerous down the stretch as the urgency is lifted. And they're up to 30 shots, is New Jersey. That's going to be icing on the Flyers. Flyers can't change as the icing is called.
Yeah, it's been a big night for Travis Konecny. In the second period, he takes a pass from Kevin Hayes. Oh. His shot goes through Brendan Smith and past Mackenzie Blackwood. Four chances on the power play. Shoot, 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 and shoot again. Konecny finally gets Blackwood. He's got a couple tonight. And the Flyers had, at that point, a 4-1 lead.
And he's on the ice now. Chuck Fletcher, the GM, said before the season, are you a 50-point guy or are you a 70-point guy? Take a player like Travis Konecny. Let's push here a little bit. Let's see what we have.
tonight they got a great effort. He did everything that Travis Konecny can do. On his way to maybe the number one star, him and Carter Hart have been difference makers tonight. Under six to go for the Devils as they try to get within one. Braun hit by Wood. Hamilton pinches aggressively all the time, but especially here in the third. Boqvist can't quite control it. Halts to Wood. And he's going to lose control, and he comes out of the zone. Miles Wood. Hughes back on the ice. Severson, who made it 4-2. Devils try to get regrouped here. Here's Holla. He'll chip it in deep. Well, it's Holla out there now with Mercer and Palat. James Van Riemsdyk fires it off the board directly, looking for a self pass. Can't quite get it, and here comes Mercer again to Palat. Gets it in deep. Beautiful play at the line by Severson. Uses his glove to Palat. One-timer shot saved by Hart. Knocked away as Mercer has a chance from distance. Throws it towards the net in the corner. Severson, the defenseman, down low.
Hart's made a couple of good saves since that second goal. He had the one in tight from Bratt, and there the one-timer he turned away from Mercer.
Bratt fakes the shot, walks in. Dishing backwards to Marino. Now he gets it, shoots it, saved by Hart.
Carter Hart hasn't played in the preseason. He's gotten busy as this period has gone on. This shot through Zamula's legs from Mercer, and Hart's still in position to get the left pad on it and keep the Flyers' lead at two.
All right, Ocala with a studio update. Two goals for you from the Rangers and Wild. It's 3-0 Rangers here. Kirill Kaprizov, Matt Zuccarello, what a tandem they already are, but will continue to be for Minnesota. But the Rangers respond. It'll be Filip Hedl, shot from the point. A little commotion in front makes it 4-1, Bucci.
Good stuff, Arda. Rangers won on opening night at home. Ray did that game with Emily and Sean McDonough.
Rangers are good. I see Lafreniere's got a couple assists. If he takes another step there, that might go a long way for them.
All right, so we'll see when Lindy Ruff pulls his goalie down too. Here goes net empty. Hughes walks in, knocked down. So the net is empty, extra attacker on. As Jack Hughes walked in all alone. So they have the right personnel and they had the right situation to do it. And they made the right move down two.
Provorov stepped up and laid a licking on Jesper Bratt, but Hughes was able to dance around. That became a dangerous chance.
See how the Devils work this. 6-on-5. Not a lot of room out there. Net is empty for the Flyers to ice this thing away. Devils got to get in the zone. They throw it around, but they don't have numbers to retrieve it. Now they get in there quickly on the puck. As Ray mentioned, you want to outnumber the Flyers. No reason not to. They do there 4-on-3. Now Hamilton. Net empty, extra attacker, Devils down two. Looking to get within one. Severson needs someone to shoot. Hamilton goes down low. Flyers pack it in. Hughes walks in, fires. Never got there. Rebound swept wide by Sharon Govich, number 17. Battle along the boards again. Two Flyers, three Devils. Now 3-on-3. Got to get one more Devil in there, as Ray mentioned. Doesn't happen, and the Flyers get it out.
A strong play on the wall here for Allison as he fought that puck out of the zone.
What a play by Hughes. Fired by Palat. Wide. Man, the way Jack Hughes can accelerate to space, stop, and then find the open man with those hard NHL passes. Goes off of Mercer. Was a little behind him, so it turns into a dump-in situation. Devils are there as the Flyers try to battle and get it out. Braun up the wall, but Hamilton's there to shovel it back in. Braun gets it back, goes up the middle. Good job by Mercer to support. Center Iceman's used to doing that. Hughes open. Hughes in front. Saved by Hart with the blocker. He's robbed Mercer all night. And he robbed him again there. Holt throws in front blindly. That's a rookie mistake. And the Flyers can ice it away. Frost, backhand wide. Puck in front, and it's knocked in and a goal. Devils knocked it in. It's Frost's goal, and that would be his second of the night. And the Flyers make it 5-2. If Tanner Luszynski gets the tap in, that's his first of his career, but it surely looks like it's going to be Frost.
But just prior to the open net, Hughes, Mercer, and Hart tracks left to right to make the blocker save off Dawson Mercer. Mercer's had a couple of really good chances here in this third period. This puck's up, it's right under the bar, but Hart makes the stop, and I think actually Dougie Hamilton's going to put this into the net.
Is right. Yep.
Yep. So that's going to be the second of the night.
Yes, it is.
For Morgan Frost. And the Flyers in John Tortorella's home opener are going to walk away with 2 points in a pretty impressive win.
Game 78 of Morgan Frost's career, and this is certainly one of the best he's had. He's been physical, delivering body checks, a little more assertive in his skating. And, of course, he's got a couple of tucks as well, which is a big bonus for the 23-year-old. He was 27th overall in 2017. One of those draft picks who's going to get plenty of rope to develop when you're picked in the first round. You're going to get chances, and he's getting his chance tonight, and he is delivering.
A couple of goals for Konechny, a couple of goals for Frost. A good night for Carter Hart. Because that probably went about as good as it could for the Flyers.
No doubt. 32 saves for Hart. So for John Tortorella in his debut and what he's trying to preach, wall battles, protecting the blue paint, getting in the face of the opponent's blue paint. They've done it all tonight. Pushing, shoving.
But, you know, there's one other part of John's personality I think that these players are going to see. John was telling the media today, look, I work, then I go home, then I come back to the rink and I go to work again. And that will be about what they'll do. Enjoy this for tonight and come back to the rink tomorrow and go to work. It's all part of building what they're trying to build, and there's going to be some bumps here, but they should enjoy the first night.
He exists on farmer's hours. He has a farm, rescue dogs, rescue horses. He and his wife, they're up early, they're in bed early, and that's what you do when you have a farm and you got all those duties and all those animals and all that stuff to do. You wake up and you go to work, and then you do it again tomorrow, you do it again the next day. You don't think about 2 months from now, 3 months from now, or even 3 years from now. It's one day at a time, and he's kind of brought that farming mentality to the Flyers. This one, you put it away, go back to work, and on to the next one. That's how it works in this league. This has been a great night for Philadelphia. Again, amidst of all this success for the undefeated Eagles and the in-the-playoff Flyers. They come in tonight in their debut as they prepare for Vancouver on Saturday. And have really put in a really good performance as the whistle blows here. Still time on the clock. And Carter Hart, for him, who's and Frost and these fans.
In a long year last year. Not much went right. The coaches Alain Vigneault and Mike Yeo. Now you come in, it's a new coach, a new era, a new regime, a new way of doing things, and you get itchy to get going, and you hope the start's good. The start went perfect tonight.
We miss him at ESPN. John Tortorella was our boy last year. He would say anything. He was fearless in his analysis. He would take on any player in the league if he didn't like what he saw. And that's why he was a successful analyst, but he was meant to be behind an NHL bench.
Oh, his love is right there. It's behind the bench.
He's home again, and he's a winner again. One in the books for Torts. Fist bumps and headbutts for Carter Hart. He's your number one star tonight. He helps goaltend the Flyers to a 5-2 win.
Oh, one of 82 in the books for both teams, and both of them looking for different sort of results. A disappointing night for the Devils after a promising preseason. They wanted to get off to a good start. It didn't happen. Back to the drawing board for game two, and the Flyers will enjoy this, a 5-2 win.
Good night, Travis Konecny. Good night for the city of Philadelphia as their Flyers come away with the win in game number one. Back to the studio, boys.
All right, Pooch, thanks very much.